Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. There was a time that the media was revered in this country. It was a time of true unbiased journalism where only the brave and intrepid dared to venture. It could be dangerous work and it could change the course of history as well. Those glory days are long gone, it would seem, and we are now left only with propagandists, fake news, and political hitmen. I could scrounge up sympathy for the media if they had done even a shred of it. Alas, I can't. They've shown their true visage once and for all during the Trump presidency. The press has become ever more outraged at criticism from President Trump over their biased coverage of politics these days. So, instead of just doing real reporting that is accurate and totally apolitical, they have decided to take a different tack. Instead of proving they are not the enemy of the American people, they have organized a coordinated attack of more than 100 newspapers on President Trump. That's right, they aren't even trying to hide it anymore. That news is from CNN's Brian Stelter. These newspapers will publish editorials attacking Trump's anti-press rhetoric this next Thursday. You know that whole notion that the press hasn't declared a reciprocal war on Trump and his supporters? Yeah, stuff like this makes that claim look like pure 100% hashtag fake news. https://t.co/mn6uxuxgun, Curtis Awick, at Curtis Awick, August 11, 2018. Trending: police make Miami Dolphins pay big price after NFL refused to enforce anthem respect. From CNN, the Boston Globe has been contacting newspaper editorial boards and proposing a coordinated response to President Trump's escalating enemy of the people rhetoric. We propose to publish an editorial on August 16 on the dangers of the administration's assault on the press and ask others to commit to publishing their own editorials on the same date, the Globe said in its pitch to fellow papers. You people aren't the story. Get over yourselves. The country has. https://t.co/linkcrow150 Mr. Volume, at Merval 74, August 11, 2018. The hubris here is simply mind-blowing. Actually, it's reminiscent of the journalist from Ezra Klein when a ton of media leftists managed to get a list they were on exposed for plotting against conservatives. This goes even further and is intentionally public in nature. It's a middle finger to America and President Trump, if you will. I have never been under the delusion that the press has an obligation to report the truth. In many communist regimes, they are the first to be taken over because they can be used for propaganda for despots. Control the communication lines of a country and you, in essence, control the people. The difference here is we are not communists, and when President Trump arrived on the scene, the true face of the media was shown for everyone to see in all its hideousness. The Democrats and the hard left are in full control of most of the media in America these days. What they report is mostly lies and biased opinion. It is almost uniformly negative towards President Trump and the right. It is the ultimate spin on reality, but Americans are not blind to this manipulation, and we are not sheep to the socialist slaughter either. Trump is by no means the first to be attacked by the mainstream media. It goes back to the days of the Founding Fathers and Thomas Jefferson. Things were vicious even back then. Nothing can now be believed which is seen in a newspaper. Truth itself becomes suspicious by being put into the polluted vehicle, he said. Sounds a lot like fake news, doesn't it? Brilliant. A coordinated effort by the press against Trump will not confirm Trump supports prior beliefs about the political motivations of the press at all. https://t.co/ockmylanth Shadowbuns of the Empire, at the Peter Wakens, August 11, 2018. Having said that, the leftist media has never been so blatant about their allegiance before. They fiercely and publicly identify with the Democrats and socialists out there. They not only act like they are an arm of the Democratic Party, they've all but declared that to be the case. The press should question the actions and stances of President Trump. That is their job. But when they spew lies and print falsehoods, they have turned from a form of a legitimate fourth estate into a political hit machine that fatally suffers from Trump derangement syndrome. The media was calling for the impeachment of President Trump since day one, and they are still going on about Russian collusion when there is not a shred of evidence that was ever the case. They no longer report on real stories such as the terroristic compound found in New Mexico that was allegedly training children to shoot up schools. Instead, they fixate on every word and tweet from President Trump, and it is always spun negatively. They swarmed to Omarosa, whose claims of racial slurs by Trump that has already been proven false by those she's claiming were involved. Or how about the more than 1,700 people shot in Chicago since the beginning of the year? The media doesn't cover it because it makes the left and their policies look bad. But Trump can't make this stuff up. MSM takes a coordinated stand against the president who complains that the MSM is always coordinating against him. https://t.co/i1omfocrew Madisonian Freedom at Madison for Freedom, August 11, 2018. Those 100-plus papers will run a negative smear job against President Trump because he is the only one calling them out for lying to the American people. They might as well write their own corporate obituaries in doing so because Americans will flee and shun them even faster. They are doubling down on media's **. It's insanity on a scale that is impressive. The media considers themselves the gatekeepers for communication and information in America. They consider Americans too dumb to pass the news these days and instead feed them what they figure they should think. It's Orwellian in the extreme. I can't wait to see this smear job and watch it expose the media even more for being the partisan hacks they have become. Right on, dude. A coordinated media effort against Trump. Way to make his point. Books 2829, at Books 2829, August 11, 2018, at Real Donald Trump goes after MSM, and people dislike MSM, specifically because of the fact that they all work together to push one, very left-leaning, narrative. This campaign ironically reinforces those feelings. I don't think this will have its intended effect. Hashtag inauthentic news https://t.co/idfongc9sp Patriot Apparel Company at Patriot Apco, August 11, 2018. Trump, the press is a unitary voice with an agenda press, we must speak our agenda with one voice. https://t.co/zrdgixtha, Wyatt Tomorrow, at Bulletproof Diction, August 11, 2018 over 100 biased and liberal rags. There. I fixed it for you. https://t.co/pcv3jakema, Lexi Doodles, Alexa Yuli, August 11, 2018 way to prove his point. https://t.co/deck7d, Patrick H. at Trogdor8768, August 11, 2018 These 100 papers officially work hand-in-hand with the DNC to produce anti-Republican propaganda. https://t.co/4zetsa6gatsky, Adam, at Adam for Trump, August 11, 2018 100 new papers need to come together and apologize to the American people for brainwashing them into believing Trump colluded with Russia, Adam, at Adam for Trump, August 11, 2018 I wonder what percentage of them support deplatforming, https://t.co/ns9ifu5j, Andrew, censorship minimalist, Glidden, at Ask Glidden, August 11, 2018 and on Friday, they'll write about Omarosa, 45's latest tweets, the 5,000th story on understanding the forgotten and 45 voters, and while they're at it, put another call to throw out the Constitution on their opinion page. Nancy M. Ruff, at 8th D Arts, August 11, 2018.